are going to start our session on the floor today. So again, always getting comfortable is the main key, and then you can just try to do your best to relax. So here we have no judgment on what we can do or not we can't do. We try to go deep into the body and make some changes that is positive for us. So a positive image is important. So let's think about that today. I'm going to sit onto the toes, sit first, so I'm on the balls of my feet. If you can't sit like this, please just sit in a comfortable position of your choosing to do the breathing. We are starting in the lower part of the belly, then expanding this breath into the middle, and the chest and the lungs expanding out. As you're exhaling, narrowing the back of the throat, pulling the belly in, relaxing the shoulders, maintaining the crown of the head lifts. Just becoming aware of the breath. The elevation of the shoulders. When you exhale, you're trying to relax them back into the places and really feeling deep muscles between the rib cage. Now I'm now going to try to get some aromatherapy oils and add that onto my relaxation. So you're just going to get few drops in your hands of your choosing, whichever one you want. If you want to relax, you can choose something like a lavender, which is quite relaxing. Here I have some sage and peppermint oils. It's a bit more invigorating for me so I don't fall asleep. There's a lot of sunshine on me today. So I will get really, really warm. Hopefully you are warm too. If you're not warm, maybe just get things that can soften your blankets and things that are nearby so you can use them when you need to. We are now going to go around the face, avoiding the eye area, releasing the oil where you can feel the smells coming up the nostrils. So that you can be more aware of the senses and how they make you feel. So if we have nice smelling environment, you're in a better mood. If the house is tidy, you're in a better mood. So remember everything that's affecting us. So if you are waking up angry and you don't want to do anything, so you end up doing nothing in the house, your anger keeps progressing as the day goes by. But even if you get up angry for some reason, maybe you're tired, you're overworked, and you start tidying the house, and then you're taking care of your body, you wash your face, take a shower, look in the mirror, just check yourself out, wear nice clothes, iron your clothes, then you start feeling nice about everything. So you can change your emotion from negative to positive. So we're going to now come off the toes, stretch into the cross-legged position here into the butterfly. So if you want to sit more comfortably, you can bring the blocks each side and that can help you. Or you can bring a block under the head, that might be a bit more helpful. Do you see how much more I can feel the legs open and I'm a bit more comfortable? So you just find a position of your choosing, whatever you feel comfortable with, so that we can be a bit more into the pose. I'm gonna relax my neck and the shoulders and stay upright here. A as we were talking about how everything is affected by our environments that we can change, like our houses, our looks, our clothes, just to get, or the smell, just to get in a better mood. So that's when everything starts changing within. So start making your space when you're practicing yoga, making your place more tidy, more open, more comfortable. You can even go into the park, find a quiet spot, put the headphones in, and start noticing the trees, the birds, noticing your mood, and why you might be feeling or thinking of certain things. Why do you always think the same? Can you change that? Can you change your trail of thought and your pattern? Noticing, even when we're crossing the road, we cross it always at the same point. We always walk on the same side of the road. We always go to bed in the same side of the bed. So we got habits. Some of them are good and okay. Some of them are not so good, but negative. So search. Search within. New habits. Simplest things. Notice each and every day what starts off your mood, what starts off the chain, where you end up always feeling the same. It's a knock-on effect. So you get up angry and you think everything's gonna be bad, and the day goes on, drags on, you have an altercation with someone, and somebody makes you angry on the streets, you are angry with the people you talk to in your supermarket, and it goes on. And then think of a scenario where you can just stop that. So you get up, you're tired, you're overworked. But then you do a little ritual for relaxation. Maybe when you're walking, you become more aware of the trees, avoiding the crowds, taking gentler, mindful steps, looking in the sky and the birds, smelling the air. And then if somebody's trying to make you feel upset about something, you're just ignoring crossing the road onto the other side to pay attention to something else instead of reacting. Just visualize how that makes you feel now.
Take a moment and relax. Release your attachments of yourself. Release your obligations. Release your attachments of yourself. Release your obligations. Fulfill yourself. Let your heart be your universe. Let your heart radiate your soul.
You can hear very similar messages.
Let your heart radiate your soul.
So thinking of
out into space around you.
How you can change within. How you can connect with your environment. You decide.
Let your back be the universe. Let the stars acupuncture. The rays of sunlight.
break, so we've been in this position for a while. You can just do a windscreen here, keeping your breath constant. Next position we're gonna get into is the caterpillar pose. So again, we're gonna try to sit nice and tall to start with, and then you can actually push in under the knees for this one, and then make it so that it's comfortable and it's getting the back of the legs open without forcing your back. And you can find your seat bones, like balancing your right and left. And inhale and lift your arms up, exhale, come forwards, inhale and look up, and exhale and relax. Now, here, we're working the back fascia line. So as you're relaxing into the pose, take sighing breaths. As you relax it, just notice the muscles. Where are you feeling the pain? Acknowledge it. Don't ignore the body's pain. It's a way to communicate to you. You're doing something. You must stop doing it. So just to take a break.
Find relaxation.
Relax. Here the back stretches. We are trying to get the face touch to the knees. Your shoulders lift the breast. Your elbows are softening up. We breathe. Last deep breath. If you can grab the feet, you pull the feet. You can really feel that stretching the balls of the feet again. The deeper and deeper you relax, the more you're going to feel the release.
In the cool warmth, the positive thought.
So think about all those muscles in between the bones of the spine stretching. Really small, small muscles that keep attach one spine to the other. Just try to relax into the breath. The deeper you breathe here, the more you're going to separate your vertebrae. So the deeper the stretch in the spine. As you're feeling the breath expanding to the belly, if you're touching the thighs, you're going to feel the stimulation in the belly also.
I want emotional stability. I want laughter. I want well-being. I want peace. I want love.
So, thinking of the positive affirmations there you're hearing. And just think about how you can put that into your life. You can repeat this to yourself.
Stable. I am humble.
as you relax and see whether you can go further. And as the session goes on, the time starts flying past. So we've already been here a long time. So let's come up and have a little calm, rebound pose. So you can stretch your chest up, take the hands behind you and move. So as we started talking about how our mood first thing in the morning can have a knock-on effect if we don't change it, if we don't take a moment to reflect why we are being negative, why something drags on, why we react the same way each and every time. What if you react differently? What else can you experience in life? Why should you have the same story each and every day? You have lots of choices when you're watching TV. You want to watch something different each day. You don't want to watch the same thing over and over again. And you are capable of applying that to your life. Looking at things differently. Seeing a different path. And you are in charge of your reactions, your emotions. You can't trust someone else to do the right thing for you. You have to do it. Next thing, I'm going to sit with one leg in, one leg out, and this is going to be the wrap here with the arm. So I'm already in cushions and this leg is being cushioned too. So if you're like that, it's going to be much, much easier. So you can keep one leg bent and you're trying to wrap your arm around, which is quite hard. So this is going to affect your upper body meridians too. And you can just go towards the knee again. We already been folding, so you should feel okay here to be able to stay. And we just try to rest everything from the mind. And notice the shoulder. You're trying to pull your fingers apart, but you can use a bend if you can't grab the fingers here. So the bend can get behind. You can pull it. Just notice the foot on the floor. You can press onto it whenever you need a little bit of a break. Every time you're sitting on the floor, we're trying to connect our root into the ground. So notice all the muscles in the anus and your pelvic floor. And you can try to relax a little. We always have to hold on to some kind of pressure there, otherwise we would just lose our faculties. So, but we don't always have to tighten. Let's try to soften those muscles. And just realize when you soften it, something in the bones of the pelvis relaxes. So you might be having blockages because you are holding on too tightly. It goes softer. Let's try to ground the tail into the floor and see what effect it takes in the spine when your hips are softened. Your neck is resting. You're breathing deep. Breathing out deep. Try to feel release. Now if you have no bones in the back, you're breathing, you're like a flower petal, all closed up together. And the moment we're gonna just stop doing this stretch and you're gonna feel like the petal of me. Just feel the petals all wrapped into each other. All waiting for the sun to come to release and express. So try to find what you want to express out if you want. So we want to express the positive thoughts. Send out what you want from your life, from your mind. What kind of life is the best for you? And why can't you have it? Relax your face, your cheeks, your jaw. Think about positive thoughts. Relax the eyebrows. And imagine the sun is coming up to warm you. And then as you relax your arms first, visualize the sunshine making you raise your spine slowly up. And then feel the arms release like you lifted your petals up into the world. Now as your eyes close, drop the knee to the side and stay here, rebounding in the seated position. If you want, you can stretch the leg out too. Now visualize all the positivity you're radiating from your heart out into the world. You will not fall victim to your own ego. You will not be conditioned to be only one way. You will not stop seeking the truth within you. You will not stop having your deepest passion and desires come to the surface. Not be afraid of living or expressing. You want to go out, you want to scream for your lungs or sing a song, you're going to do it. You're going to run to the hills, climb the mountains. Admit to someone you love them. It doesn't matter. Don't be afraid to feel. Just make sure you're not getting stagnant. Things are moving. Constantly looking, searching, healing, being, living. We are going to go back into our cocoon again. So now we're going on the other side. So I'm going to stretch my leg on the other side and my other arm. So you might feel one side is going to feel completely different. It's fine. It's okay. You now know that it's going to be normal. That we can just hold. Don't force your shoulder. Just try to round it forward and then relax into the face. Notice the differences. Don't judge it. It's normal, one side is always dominant, so it's normal, one side feels more tighter, and the other side doesn't feel as connected. Side attention away, breathe, and breathe some more. We've been practicing, meditating on different ways, different thoughts, breaking these trail of thought, changing the chain reaction, and not start noticing what causes this row of feelings from escalating, coming out of anger. What causes that? What starts it from? Trigger points. Sometimes you say to yourself, this is the way it is, and then you almost like come always end up in the same point because you don't think there is another way. just start noticing these trigger points. Sometimes people tend to trigger this. Sometimes you're in a toxic relationship, somebody tells you you can't do anything better and you believe it. Sometimes it's just your negativity because you don't want to work hard. So let's search the reasons so that we can avoid this trigger.
Release your attachments of yourself.
Let's listen to what he's saying and try to rest.
Release your attachments of yourself. Release your obligations. Fulfill yourself. Let your heart be your universe. Let your heart radiate your soul.
Every muscle, every joint.
Let your back be the universe. Let the stars, acupuncture, brilliant like rays of sunlight. Let your back be the universe. Let the stars, acupuncture, like rays of sunlight. Let them melt into a new place.
Relaxing the spine, relaxing the arms, relaxing the tension, relaxing your pelvic floor. Soften, connect to the ground.
Succumb to that.
Find your own truth. It's in there.
Breathe in. And let it go. Relax now.
Notice how you're back in the cocoon, the petals. You're getting restless to express again. When we come out to open, have all the thoughts that you want to have, all the positive affirmations. Let's radiate them out into the universe. So start finding the right information. Relax your arms like your petals coming together. Soften the shoulders.
Massage your chest.
Soften your jaw and your cheeks.
Massage your stomach. Massage your hips. Massage your thighs.
Now slowly release the arms first. Feeling the arms really tired now. Your legs gonna feel tired. So you're just gonna rebound. You can recline onto the wall. You can change the position of the legs. And imagine you're opened up to the sunshine again. Breathe. Relaxing your back. You want to be the sunshine. You want to give up the tension. You will not give in to your ego. You will not give in to your conditioning. You can change. When you want to, if you want to, you can change anything. You can be different feeling each moment and second. Trust yourself. Trust the universe. Trust your instincts.
Be in love.
Begin gonna chant Om to finish our session. Big loud Om. Together, bring your hands to your face, your cheek, your chest. If you like, you can lie down one.